Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you the presidential candidate from the Affectionist Party, Rico Suave.
My friends, neighbors, fellow citizens, when you think of a leader, what are some qualities that you look for? Should not the connections that we share as a community be the most important thing? You all here have a relationship. Brother, sister, daughter, neighbor, friends, American. You see, by myself, I can accomplish close to nothing. But together, we can make a difference. Today, we can affect the world. Today, I, Rico Suave, am announcing my presidential candidacy. Let us embark on this journey for the future of our nation. You see, it takes two to tango, and together we can cause motions that can make ocean waves. For every person that enters your life, a footprint is left in the sand on the beach of your soul. I would like to share with you, America, those that have left imprints in my life. Our story begins on the opposite side of the world, where my mom, a young Filipino medical attendant in the Philippines during World War II, nursed my injured American father back to fighting health. My father, Rick, whose descendants hailed from Italy and Scotland, felt my mother's grasp on his hand and felt a wonderful union. They both were in love, and when my father came back to the States, my mother soon followed because their passion did not recognize the boundaries the ocean set upon them. My father, Rick, was a major general in the 544, and after getting married, he lost his legs after doing an overseas mission in the Vietnam War. When he came back to my birthplace in Boston, Massachusetts, he did not give up hope. He told my mother and my young self that even through the darkest of his days in war, he would sleep soundly because he knew the sun would always rise the next day. With these words, I worked hard to make the most out of my life. Even though he had lost both of his legs, my father was a constant model of perseverance, winning 3 Olympic gold medals for track, swimming, and luge. While he was winning medals, I was graduating from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology with high honors in applied sciences. I also invented the Pope Bat Note, the 4-blade laser, and the Snuggie. My four years spent at MIT are some of the fondest memories and the experiences of my life. The prestigious school gave me the tools to be as successful as I wanted to be. As a young man, I began to take my education very seriously, understanding how important education is to success in my life. I chose a combination of applied sciences and economics. I learned that we need to better our understanding of how to utilize wind power, water power, solar energy, and geothermal energy. Every week, my campaign team and I will hold interactive, renewable energy lectures on how each and every one of you can make a difference. See, the economy is another issue. Make no mistake, America, our economy is in the worst shape it has been in since the Great Depression. But like my mother used to always say, yung hindi lumiyon sa pinanggalingan ay hindi makadating sa corona, which means that if you can't look to your past, you can never face your future. We must learn from the mistakes in the past, the way that we have been living our lives in a self-serving manner, because if we are together, we are strong. After all of this schooling, my family and I moved to the rural town of Catskills, North Dakota. I went into politics with the notion that together, we could change the town that I resided in. After being mayor for 5 years, I tried to run for the governor position, but even though I lost a bid 4 times, I never gave up, and ended up with a Senate seat to represent my state. With my energy-saving regulation bill and my views on the economy, I secured my seat in the Senate for another 4 years because of the notion that I'm trying to show that we can all grow together as a family. Now, my whole family occupies a large part of my heart. My wife, Diane, my 9-year-old son, John, my 5-year-old daughter, Susie, and my 13-month-year-old daughter, Lulu, whom we adopted from Africa just last month. See, my kids have taught me a valuable lesson. In this short time, one of these important lessons is patience. Now, I know what you're thinking, Rico. How can we wait? We are in a state of economic crisis. But I tell you this, if we run into a fire unprepared, we will only get burned. We must prepare in unity. That's what we are, America, the United States. Not the states that are like sort of friends, not the connected states, but only by the borders, but the United States. We are only as strong as our weaknesses, and as one, we must defeat all obstacles. We must work together, amalgamated, in order to ensure that one day, our descendants will not have to know the economic struggles faced by their generations. I am reminded of my family friend, Tiny Tim. Now, I call him Tiny Tim because it has been his nickname since the age of 5 when his family found out that their son Timothy would never grow up. You see, Tim suffers from a condition that does not allow him to grow past 2 feet and 4 inches from the ground. As if it is not hard enough for this young man to find a job, his father Kevin just lost his local business. Kevin owned a small deli that was forced to close when Walmart came to town, and my last visit with Tiny Tim truly touched my heart because as we walked hand in hand by the new Walmart, Tim looked up at me and with a single tear he said, "Rico, how can a little guy like me survive in a big store like this?" And when I looked into his eyes and I could feel his pulse through his wrist, I then noticed that even though he was small in stature, his heart was the same size, if not bigger. So now I want to tell Tim that we, America, have not forgotten about him and those small businesses that have made America the amazing nation that it is today. With the Affectionists together, we can show that through love and through unity, we can fix any problem that we have. And if we keep an attitude of optimism and affection, we can all be satisfied with the results for ourselves and our future. It takes two to tango. Join me, America. It's me and you. Let's dance.